assignment is to develop a strategy to coach baseball or how to throw a pitch a ball. They would actually have to record themselves going through the steps of the mechanics of throwing a ball. Then the instructor would then grade that assignment with the rubric, and then given the rubric that you would grade it, and then give those points to that individual student. So again, the coaches, students would level up by the end of the course, or that was the theory, by the end of the course, they should have an intrinsic value. They would care for their student that they're nurturing, and basically, as long as they do good in the class, their fictional student would. Again, we followed the same premise that Leticia de Leon, Dr. De Leon, did in her reading class that Ram was mentioning that we had pull numbers from also. So we by word wanted to replicate it in a different manner. And again, motivation action.
Okay, so this is what the framework looks like. We have course goals, gamification goals, right, from a questionnaire that we give them. And I didn't get a copy of the questionnaire, but there's a questionnaire that that we use in our office to ask faculty, okay, you want to gamify this course, do you have this and this and so on. So gamification goals, the user type characteristics of the student, just like what you were talking about, and an overall story. If you're going to macro gamify it, then you need, what is the big story? Is it about a scenario that involves whatever discipline you're working on? For example, kinesiology student to begin actual careers as coaches, right? So if you're teaching kinesiology, your overall story would be let's put the students into that role that they're going to be coaches. And hey, that motivates students. Oh, I want to be part of that. I want to learn how to be a coach. So the second level, the second page that they work on is the learning objectives. So they put the learning objectives. You always have to have an onboarding. I don't know if the latest apps that you or applications on the computer that you download will tell you, okay, here you get, here's your files. Over here, you want to upload a file. And so that's onboarding. That's what onboarding means. You kind of give your audience where to start, how to begin. Storyline, call to action, hero's story, activity loop, game mechanics. So this helps faculty develop the course. It's a blueprint, it's a framework, just like our other one, but it's aimed at gamifying the course.
Again, we're trying to scaffold it just like we do in our blueprint process. We have module ones and unit ones, but we're kind of segmenting it as level ones. So think of this as an overlay on top of our original blueprinting process. And we always keep alignment and focus when we're doing the gamification. Now, in the previous slide, there was, again, what do you want the game to do, or what do you want the game mechanics to do in the course? So we asked, what behaviors do you want to change? And in this case, like Ram's course, the attendance.
I wanted to change that behavior of the attendance.
So, and then we go to the next step is, okay, what type of students do you have? You have graduate students, they have certain technical. We ask, we know basically what the user types are, what type of student level these are. Then once we go through that process, then this goes back to we want the blueprinting part done, because this is actually the fun part. The blueprinting part is the fun part, because this is where creativity can reign, and we can start saying, okay, well, the students first week, usually they have to do an introduction. So we ask them to do a storyline. So week one intro, if they have a game gamification in mind, so like the kinesiology class I was mentioning, the storyline would be students are introduced to their own students and given basically a card or what have you, information package about their student, and you are assigned to so-and-so Gary or Karen. She is a so-and-so student at Blank Elementary. She is a Blank grader. Basically giving them the information, like, and we would actually work with the instructor asking them, okay, well, why are you saying this? And again, at the same time, does that align with the objectives or module objectives you originally posted? You don't want to go too far askew with your story that you miss or are just taking the student away from your original learning objectives. And we just try and keep that in check. That's why we have one on top of the other.
Okay, so what's next? Well, we've developed this framework. We want to develop more courses, and we have two slated for fall 2016, which means we will start working on them this semester and through summer. We have this meta-analysis that I'm working with another faculty member, and looking at top journals and looking at the threads of the trends of what is being covered. We also want to look at the retention factors, but before we do that, obviously we've got to develop some of these courses. When we develop the courses, it's the understanding that we will survey students, we will look at the data and see what they're saying. We're also trying to recruit additional faculty to develop and do research in this area. We've got quite a bit of other things going on. This is just a little part of what we do, and we try to involve
not mentioned there, and that's something I'm looking at personally, is game elements. If you saw the three columns, there's a huge amount of them, and I left many of them out and how they correlate with each other. But there are one or two studies of which game elements utilized in courses can be or show potential. So again, is storytelling the best game element to utilize in a class? Or can we say that leaderboards or points badges and leaderboards are successful? You don't know, then that's where most of the next part of the study is going to come. Which game elements actually are going to help with this action? Like, if that will help prove that gamification will succeed in the future.
And again, you got to have a little bit of the intrinsic and a little bit of the extrinsic motivation in the course. And that's, you know, that flow, trying to keep the students in that flow. So let's open up the session to questions and answers.
Yes.
It's an interesting concept. Just a question, what's the faculty buy-in right now?
Well, we have had one instructor develop, and we have two that are interested in developing courses. And one additional faculty member that I'm working with on the meta-analysis, and he is also interested in down the road developing something.
And what we're using in terms of motivation for them, so we're going to provide some stipend so they can join the force and expense
customer. That always helps, right?
Yes.
Sure.
And of course, provide that.
It was until last year when we first presented this concept at our own conference, our internal conference, we actually got several faculty that approached us and were ready to go. However, that's why I had to revise my portion where it's not a cure-all. So you have to go back and figure out, is the course set in stone already? Is the foundation set so we can apply maybe gamification upon it? That's where now we're going to the next phase. Yes.
You're already using the QM process, right, which makes for a good course, and you're just adding this as a layer to help the students stay in the course.
Well,
help the faculty develop something too.
But the QM notion, right, is that this is a great course, right? I mean, everything's aligned. And it's really for that online audience that has to self-teach, right, through a course that they don't need an instructor in. I mean, technically, they wouldn't need it technically. So this is, how do you decide? Was it the QM process that made the course better, made the students learn at a greater rate or whatever, ABCD? I mean, do you have those kind of assessments in mind, or was it the gamification of the QM?
Well, we definitely have that in mind for research purposes. Looking at a course that has not been gamified versus the same equivalent that's been gamified, preferably from the same instructor. So, yeah.
But see, there is a difference.
Yes, before we even got into this, we said we got to research this. If we start doing this, we got to look if it's something that's helping. Because if it's not, then why do it, right?
Go back to QM. I mean, it's always self-improvement. Although it's been taught for 2 years, you still have to go back and revise it. So what we're saying is this might be an option. And we presented as a four-hour workshop at QM, and we got the same question that was brought up, comparative-wise. We're on that. We're pursuing.
By the way, this was actually a 4-hour presentation. We cut it down to 1 hour.
Yeah, there was game awards and everything.
There was game, there was fun, there was prizes.
Are you seeking specific type of faculties, faculty members to participate in the project or the initiative? I mean, the thing is that my sense is that it will be easier to implement in certain type of courses.
Right.
So are you looking to specific faculty?
Yes, faculty that preferably have developed a course that Quality Matters, that are Quality Matters certified. Definitely helps, because if you go to someone that's never used Quality Matters, and then you got to teach that part first, right? They have to learn how, what assessments are, what objectives are, what is alignment, and so on. So yes, preferably somebody that's already in the system that's been working with us, Quality Matters.
As for subject, I don't think we would turn anyone away. If any discipline that's come in, we want them to share that adventure with us, and we want to help pursue gamification with them. One of the studies actually wasn't mentioned. They had said that math and science had the best capabilities for gamification because of the application. So you can easily turn like an engineering class, talk about you're an engineer, you have to span this distance, what's the correct formula? And so that I think
history would be.
But it goes back to, let's not fall into that pit that this is just a buzzword. Let's explore those routes. That's what we want to do. And that's one of the conversations we had at QM, where some individuals were kind of battling with us on that. Yes.
So are you I hear you're going to do it at your university, right? That's your focus. You're bringing better quality to your university. But, it seems to me that it could be something that you could offer as an online to instructors to bring gamification to them without having to be connected to your university. I mean, I don't know if you thought about that. But you are in the online business, and you are in the business of looking at gamification as a motivator. And if you find, if you see significant results, that would be certainly a product you could bring to others without them having to be associated with your university.
I don't know what's in the cards, but
maybe further down the road. First, we got to find out if this is really something that's going to help students.
With all the work and reading I put in, I really hope it is. I've invested a lot of time on this, and I truly enjoy the idea of breaking things down.
Grant Theft Auto says that it is.
Yeah.
It will work, right?
Regarding the history class, I think we know political science. We were at that CUNY conference, and one of the presentations, the individual pulled elements from Clue. He actually gave a packet, and then the students had to guess what was in the packet throughout the length of the entire semester. And he's gotten good praise, and he has retention rates, actually. I can try and find his name.
I've seen it the other way around. They used some Microsoft gaming tools to have students develop and create type of SimCity, create a whole city based on some economical, political mindset. They have to work and build the whole city based on that.
Right now, in K-12, one that's being heavily used in Minecraft, the creation capabilities.
Have you seen those children
engaged
in that building Minecraft? My two kids, that's all they do. And that's what, that's why I'm really interested in this motivation part, because I kept asking them to do things, but they're on the iPad and you can't get them off the iPad. So there's some motivator there that maybe we can tap into as educators. And that's what we're
There is another article where they're trying to use MMORPG, so basically the large maps where everyone can come in and discuss things. But in this case, the levels or the quests are actually a scavenger hunt assignment, so the students would have to travel in this fake universe and have to look for assignments. And information that the instructor kind of sporadically added everywhere. There's no fighting, it's just discussing and completing certain levels. I think it's in its beginning stages, like I said, mostly everything that is out there is in its infancy, especially in our field. So it's worth pursuing and worth looking into further, so we can add to it. I think that's the cool part of it, is that we're in a part where we can add to the application study.
Okay. Any other questions before we turn? Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Well, thank you.
Oh, all the references are on the part. I know it's going to be available. A lot of them are really good on here.
Well, thank you so much for your attention. Thank you for the team and University of Texas for sharing this important presentation with us. I would really kind you to hand me back the evaluation form. If someone doesn't have it, please tell me so I can hand it in. Really,